What really brought me to this place was when I came for interview, the wealth of knowledge and the breadth of cases that were done here, that included, you know, everything from the basic to the complex procedures, was actually the main reason why I selected this place. In fact, I selected this place despite having matched to an accredited program. I still took this place because I thought this was a place where I would really learn vascular surgery better than many other accredited places, where people actually looked at me a little strange, say, hey, do you know you are going to a program that's not even accredited? However, I selected to do this because of really the faculty I met and the potential I saw in what I would learn. Everybody knows how for years and years we had the 5+2. So you do general surgery and then you come to do your fellowship that lasts 2 years. In some places, the 2 years will include 1 year of basic science and 1 year of, you know, surgical, basically clinical work. We have always had a 2 year fellowship that's all clinical. The integrated program is clearly something that we have now had for maybe 8 years or so, and it is clearly something that fits the need of new generation of medical students, people who really know what they want to do. And I was probably a little bit more skeptical at the beginning. However, we can see actually with confidence that over time, by making some adjustments, we have really gotten to a point where I personally feel very confident that we train and actually graduate through the integrated program as competent as they can get. And of course, that did not happen right away, and it needed to be adjusted. There are a lot of things that habits from learning in general surgery bring, you know, with you. But I can see actually with great, you know, confidence, I can say that the integrated program is here to stay, and it's really doing well, and I have no problems you know, with people going through the both programs. And the differences are probably that the general surgery trained individuals have a much more access and knowledge and know-how about other pathologies and how to do surgery in hernias or gallbladders, but the integrated vascular surgery residents definitely will be absolutely competent in what they can do in vascular surgery. So I think I have always said as a strength of this program, you know, I have always seen the fact that the trainers themselves have different backgrounds in terms of, you know, where they trained, because that's what they bring. And so what that then automatically provides for the trainee in our program is the opportunity that the trainees will basically have probably a hybrid way of, you know, developing their skills that will, by taking the best out of everybody. And so I have always considered that to be a strength. And there is, you know, Dr. Aker, who trained in Houston, Dr. Hawk, who trained in Missouri, myself, I trained by multiple trainers that came from different areas, and you can imagine, I mean, the list is long. And so I think our junior faculties are also from different, you know, institutions, and so I think they add really tremendously to what we can teach our residents. You are alluding to another strength of the program, which is really well balanced in a way that we really don't have any problem operating in the old way. if we need to do that, and also telling the patient what might be best for them based on the data and, of course, best practices that we see. And in fact, we are one of those great referral places for complex procedures, including the open thoracoabdominal aneurysm cases or complex, you know, visceral reconstructions. We have, from endovascular perspective, in almost all clinical trials for complex new devices that are out in the market. And so what happens is, therefore, we can say in our institution, we are the place where complex endovascular procedures are performed, and therefore we can do with confidence, and it is not with a spirit of competition of any sort. It's really what is best for the patients, and we can make those decisions without any problems. And so we are really fortunate to be in some kind of a little bit of a different academic island when you look at things compared to other programs across the Midwest. And people will be exposed to all the complexities that they should be exposed to a point where sometimes you wonder, you know, if those complex things are going to be in the future fellowships. But here it is not. Here it is part of the regular training that we provide. I think the global surgery exposure in general probably comes because of my connection to what I do, not only with the American College of Surgeons, but also with the Department of Surgery itself. I understand a lot of times when people think about global surgery, they think about general surgery. However, if you look across the globe, the burden of peripheral vascular disease is over 200 million individuals, you know, sick from this. And so the opportunities to go and teach and to go and provide care is absolutely there as much as the hernias or the gallbladders. And so we took this opportunity to develop actually a vascular surgery residency program in an institution in Ethiopia, where our residents have the opportunity to go and participate for at least a month in any aspect of the care or do research with them. But there is also possibilities in the future actually expanding that and to other countries as well. This opportunity of global health really makes us stronger, part of the worldly community. We really may go and see some challenging situations, which at some point may actually become the reason for innovation, something new, something different. And going to different cultures, meeting people from completely different continent, actually makes us better human beings. And it really adds value as a physician to really care for those who don't have the means. And so it really is also satisfying, actually, for the soul and the mind and everything. It is, global surgery is an area where the service we provide has no transactionality. You are really being the doctor. And so it really adds tremendously to who we are as physicians. And we value that absolutely. And time is reserved for anyone who wants to have that experience. I really value the camaraderie and the friendship I see within our trainees. I think they are a very close, neat, you know, individuals who not only care about the work they do, but also care for each other and socially. I really, really do think also that part of the fabric involves also faculty. Faculty are not living on a different island, but they are really across their rooms, you know, and it's easy to approach and talk to, call on the cell phone, you know, and so I really do feel strongly that our educational environment and community is very much on a playing field. And so I think that is really one of the strongest, you know, probably one, because you said one thing, so the strongest thing I value the most. Well, you know, medicine, you know, depends on your personal needs, right? So for me, medicine was the right place to, because I had a young family, I had, you know, two kids, which I wanted to be in the best school district. I wanted it to be in a public health school district. And so that fitted that thing for me. And so that was one. I really do think it's a very small town, but brings all the values that a college town brings with it, be it from, you know, the outside entertainment perspective, be it the restaurants, the theaters, whatever, the music scene, whatever you want. Those are really actually, you know, up to speed with any city in the Midwest. Chicago is not too far for someone who wants a lot more action and go to high-end, you know, jazz places. However, I can guarantee you probably more Chicago people come to Madison to have fun than people from Madison going to Chicago. I think the city itself is a very peaceful city. I feel the city has, for example, the lowest homicides. Crime is not really a big issue. You know, you turn your TV on, you know, the first news you hear is not, you know, how many people are shot. And I mean, those were things that really I really valued. And the safety was really a very important aspect for me. And, you know, and I think the university itself, and particularly the Department of Surgery, has this community of residents and trainees and faculty that really make it special. The hospital is amazing because it has all the support you need to take care of your patients. Everybody works from understanding their responsibility. And so I don't have to call radiology 10 times to do an x-ray. I don't have to call escort to come and pick the patient. I don't have to reach out to consults and call the consult teams to come and see my patients. So everybody does their part. And so it is a whole thing that is really phenomenal to me and important to me.